About to switch sides on you.
When Blake Dean landed Eric Orsi for the class of 2018, Orsi was a significant signee for Dean and the UNO baseball program.
Yeah, right there, right there.
The 6'4" pitcher had a very solid 2017 season at Northwest Florida State Junior College. 61 strikeouts in 66 innings.
A guy that we thought would come in and do a great job for us. And in the fall, you know, he was one of our best pitchers.
They were kind of looking for me to be Sean Semple's replacement, having lost him the year before, getting drafted to the Yankees.
But his first year at UNO wasn't even close to that. 15 earned runs in 16 innings with an ERA of just over 8, even after a very productive fall.
Something wasn't clicking, something wasn't right. We couldn't really figure out what was going on.
Orsi was playing with abdominal pain, something that came and went. But finally, near the end of the 2018 season, he had enough after the third or fourth time.
Like 4:30 in the morning, I was asleep. Woke up screaming in pain, had to go to the hospital, something just more, not necessarily worried that something was super wrong, just something to kill the pain was what I was looking for.
And while Eric was in a hospital, he had an ultrasound performed on him. 1 hour later, the doctor came back and gave him the news that he did not want to hear. He was diagnosed with testicular cancer. At 21 years old, hearing you have testicular cancer, what went through your mind?
At first, I laughed at the doctor when he told me. You just don't expect something like that. And then about 5 minutes into it, I just remember looking down at my hand, shaking, and I just lost it, started crying like a baby.
From there, he had surgery in late May to remove a tumor, and the right-hander was labeled cancer-free. But then in July, the doctors found swollen lymph nodes, and as a precaution, had a second surgery to remove those lymph nodes. And everything seemed to be looking good. Until later that summer, Orsi was back in the hospital for shortness of breath. A doctor told Orsi he had a mole on his back and to visit a dermatologist, which he did, where he was informed he had skin cancer, with one mole being melanoma.
You have cancer for the second time within 3 months.
Right.
What were you thinking at that point in time?
I was a little off more than anything. Like, I was just hoping to put all this behind me and get back on the field and get ready to go for the next season. It wasn't anything too crazy. It was just more kind of a nuisance at that point. And I think I have 4 scars from that. So it was like as soon as I got one done, I'd go back a month later and they'd be like, oh, we found another one. So it just kind of got annoying at that point.
Orsi sat out the entire 2019 season, but the team didn't forget about him wearing these Team Orsi bracelets the entire season.
All the local families that were here, families that were coming down from out of state watching their kids on certain weekends. It was unbelievable.
And now he's healthy, ready to be the ace pitcher he planned on being a couple years ago for the Privateers.
If he stays healthy and does what he's supposed to do, he'll be a big anchor to our pitching staff.
If that's not my role, it's okay. It's more of just a personal goal. But I mean, it means a lot just having gone through all this and kind of growing up a little bit earlier than I thought I would need to.
Sharif Ishak, WDSU News.